Welcome, Rattler fans, to another episode of Talking Rattlers, where the banter is never out of season. I'm Brian Maglioan, and on this episode, we take a look back at the Heartland Conference Tournament, which was played right here at the softball stadium inside the park at St. Mary's University, where the St. Mary's Rattlers were victorious in winning the Heartland Conference title. Also on this episode, we will take a look into the regional tournament, which will be played here as well later this weekend, so stick around. Right now, we'll toss it over to Joe Rodriguez and myself from this past weekend as we interviewed two of the stars of the Heartland Conference Tournament.
And welcome, everyone, to the softball field. Joe Rodriguez and Brian Maglioan, joined by the Heartland Conference Pitcher of the Year, Viana Gutierrez Touchstone, and the Heartland Conference Player of the Year, Nicole Sarlich. And both of you now can call yourself Heartland Conference Tournament Champions. Had to be an exciting one. Viana, a tough pitching battle in this one. You and DeBrow always seem to go at it. What were you able to do in order to come out on top today?
Just stay ahead of the batters and just knowing that my pitches were going to be working and just being confident on the mound really is what helped me.
And Nicole, you came up big in the sixth inning with that solo shot. The first pitch of the inning, what was going through your mind when you stepped into the box?
Well, honestly, just hitting the ball. I knew she was probably going to do the low inside. It's usually what she's been beating me with. So as soon as I saw it, I just, you know, went for it. And it ended up being a home run. So it's good.
And then in earlier news this week, you were named the top 10 finalist for National Player of the Year. I know you told me 2 years ago before the season you wanted to be an All-American both as a batter and a hitter. It seems like you've accomplished that goal. How do you feel about being named to the top 10? And what more do you have to work toward for the rest of the season?
It feels awesome. I know for sure our work is not done yet, and look forward to regionals now and just taking it one game at a time, and we'll go from there.
And Viana, you mentioned regionals. How do the both of you and your team prepare for the regional tournament in just a week's time?
Just being focused. Being focused and just preparing mentally, physically, any way that we can for the opponents that are to come our way, because I know that we have a big target on our back. Yeah. So
one game at a time is going to be the main focus, you know.
And y'all have a very good group of seniors. Do you think that that's going to be something that you're going to be able to fall back on as you head it further on into the deep parts of the year?
I mean, I feel like we have a pretty good amount of experience. So having that group and having that confidence that we have, it's going to help a lot, I feel.
Well, the Rattlers are your Heartland Conference postseason champions once again. From the softball here field here at St. Mary's, I'm Joe Rodriguez. He's Brian Maglioan. Thank you so much for joining us, ladies. For more Rattler news, be sure to check out rattlerathletics.com.
We are now joined by Ruben Dominguez. Ruben will be calling the South Central Regional on the Rattler Network. And Ruben, how excited are you about this weekend?
Well, I think it should be a great weekend showcasing some of the best teams in the South Central region. We're looking forward to it here at the park at St. Mary's, and I couldn't be more pleased that we're able to host it as a university.
And last weekend, St. Mary's hosted the Heartland Conference Tournament, which saw the Rattlers come away victorious. What were some of your thoughts and takeaways from that weekend?
Well, I think Donnafield's team did really good at doing what they needed to do to get that victory in the championship game. They had a star performance from Nicole Sarlich, who ended up winning the Heartland Conference MVP, and also some clutch pitching performances from Viana Gutierrez Touchstone as well. So I think they can take that momentum into this weekend and hopefully come away with another crown.
And this weekend, the Rattlers have added tests to go through. Who are some of the teams in this tournament to look out for?
Well, the Rattlers are going to take on in the first round Texas Women's University. Now, Texas Women's was here at the park at St. Mary's for the opening tournament, the Rattler Invitational, earlier this season. So they know what the Rattlers are all about, so they'll be up for that matchup. And whatever team gets out of that matchup will face the All-Colorado game of Metro State and Regis. So it should be some good competition, and we're really looking forward to it.
Some good competition, a lot of fun, and you could catch it on rattlerathletics.com. For Ruben Dominguez, I'm Brian Maglioan. Before we go, we'll take you back to the Heartland Conference Tournament as we look at some of the sights, the sounds, and the images that made it the weekend that was.